So in this class today we discuss the Power BI's visualizations. In the Power BI have visualizations, we have the maximum tools of the visualization. This is very important because we have connect the data and go through the visualization and show your reports, show your analysis, show your summary. So first need to connect your data. So I have connect the data. I have the one data, I just go to the downloads, the IT data one. And we have a lot of the visualizations. We conduct one by one every visualizations and everything with visualizations. So in the Excel visualization called charts. So we discussed on the Power BI charts. So we have connected our data. And when you connect the data, you have got the fields. Very few minutes. So we have connect the data, and first we discuss about the tables. We have the tables, first tables and matrix tables. So when you have used the tables, it's like I have put the name here. We got the name here. I want to quantity of T numbers. You can also give the T numbers, but when you give the T numbers, here is the completely T number, because in the T numbers we have text. So text count the sum. If you have put here like total numbers, you can got the sum. And when you there is your data fields, see here you have the sum of the sign here. Which field have the sum of the sign here? This that called numbers fields. And which the calendar symbol, we have the date fields, and this is the sum of the again number fields. And we have not any symbol before the field name, that called text. So when you put the text, you can got the complete details, and when you put the numbers, got the sum. This is the sum, but I want to total T number, the counts. So when you put here, and this is the arrow key, down arrow key, click on the down arrow key and see here counts. You can count and okay, you got the number of counts. So this is the value fields. You have put the your numbers, your fields, you got the tables here. But table is a summarized table, because in the data Amar have multiple times, but on the your dashboard page Amar show the one time, just like pivot table in the Excel pivot table. Okay, but I want to show the report with two matrix. Just like I want to also show the status, okay, how many tickets numbers by a status. When you put the status in here, you can see like that every status will be one by one, but I want to matrix format just like pivot table. So that time we need to create the matrix table. Click on the matrix table and you have got here row and column wise. This is the row wise name and column wise your status. It is clear, sir? Ms. Krishnan, So we have the two tables. First is the normal tables and second the matrix tables. So do you want to report on the table like a pivot table? We use the matrix table. Okay? In the matrix tables, we have got the three criteria. First the row, second the column, and third the your values. Where you sum and calculate your fields. So if you have also switch, just like I want to name in the column and status in the row. So I have just swap here and name to columns. You can show you this table, the reports. And every visualization have a formatting. This is the formatting symbol. This is the paintbrush symbol. This is the formatting symbol. Click on this paintbrush symbol. We have multiple criteria of your formatting. first is the general, and this formatting update according to the visualizations. Every visualization have a different type of your formats. First, the general, this is the general setting, your positions, what is your position, what is height and width, alt text, when you click on cursor, so the text is the alt text. A style, you have default style, you can also change the minimal style, you can change your style here, bold header, header will be bold and colored, alternative row here, finished row. So we have the different type of the styles. You can style here, select here. Second, the grid, do you want to apply the your bold header? This is the, also style, we have click on the grid. So you have the vertical grid, click, your grid will be shown there, like that. See here, your grid will show. Grid called borders, and this is the grid color. I want to apply grid color on the red, so click here, see your red color. Your thickness, you can also decide here your grid thickness. And do you want to horizontal grid on and also off here. And this is the horizontal grid colors. You can apply the different color, same color for the horizontal. This is the different thickness of the your horizontal grid. Row shading, you can also apply the row shading. Outline colors, everything will be here. And this is the column header. You can also apply the column header here. You can also select the font header here. There just we have select the font color like a black by row, and the background color we have applied the background color, the different color. See here your background color, header background color, column header, and you also apply the header colors here. And this is the outline. Bottom only, top only, top plus bottom, you can show outline. This is the raw header, this is the values. You can also see here, this is the background, if you want to background color, and border, shadow, and tooltip. So you have also select here visualization, and this is the analytics. There is a no analytics because analytics depending on your visualization. See, in the table, we have no any analytics. So do you understand tables and table formatting, Mr. Krishnan?
Yeah.
And after that, we have discussed about the on the charts. We have used the SCAT charts. Okay, this is the SCAT charts. When you put here name, this like I have put the name, and when you this is the no any what. When you put your value in the value section, then you can see the series. So this is the customer rate, time taken. We have put on the value here. See here, value. And this is the legend. When we have go the status on the legend. So see here, part of. Because this is the SCAT bar chart. But I want to every different series, so we have used the cursored bar chart. When you cursor the bar chart, every status we have the separate bar. But when you use the SCAT bar chart, we have the partition of the your every persons. Mr. Yogesh, this is the total sales, and this is the part of the acknowledgement, college, and open the status files. So you have decide which visualization you want to show on the your reports, and you can also there's a SCAT column chart, same SCAT column, and this is the cursor column. In the cursor column have a different every each column by status. and this is the bar chart. And second is the 100% escape chart. 100% escape chart, this is the contribution. This is every line will be the same, but your contributions according to the percentage. Okay, total, this like you guys have a total 355, and in the total 355 have opened how many percent? This is the show here, 29.31%, and close is the 48.45%, and this is the 268, it means close by 22%. So this is the contributions, and also this is the 100% column charts. So this is the columns according the bar and cursor. And every visualization have a formatting here. You can show here, we have the different formatting. This is like general, like that, legends, X, Y axis, Z axis. You can, this is the your axis. If you have X axis off, there is a no your axis. And now show, just like Y axis, you have visualize. Also on zoom inside, you can also zoom here. You have the data, if a lot of the data, you can include the zoom slicer, right sir? This is a zoom slider, and in the zoom slider y-axis is on. We have an slider labels. You can want to slider label, we'll show the slider label. You want to know slider label, uncheck here. You can also remove the Y axis, and we have used the zoom slider level. And data colors, this is the data labels. You want to show on the data labels, click here, and this is the data labels. You can also format your data labels. Here is the formatting for your data labels. You can format your data labels. Now total, this is the total labels. You can select here, you can see the total layer. And plot area, we have, do you want to transparency, 0% transparency, do you want to give the transparency, okay, visible the back end side, we have entered here transparency. You can also add the image. If you want to add the image, you can also here add the image. And you want to show the image in the background image, then we have used the transparency. And this is the titles. There is the titles. Time taken by name and status. If you want to hide your titles, you can select here. If you want to hide your backgrounds, select here, your background will be hide. Also border, shadow, everything. And this, there is the analytics. This is the analytics, because analytics depending your visualization. So we have used the stack bar chart. We have given the constants line. So we have entered the constants line on the 50%. And we have changed the color to black. This is the black. And your value, your constants, where you show, I am right here, 800. So here is the 800. Okay, so we have show the constants line on the 800. When you change your column chart type, we have chart type, and you can show same relations, same. And when you show your charts, we have cursor column chart, we can get the multiples your analytics. So your formatting and your analytics change by update by your visualizations. Different visualizations have a different options. Yeah. छोटा हुआ। इसमें कंसिस्टेंस लाइन, मिनिमम लाइन, मैक्सिमम लाइन, एवरेज लाइन, यू कैन ऑल्सो एंटर एट द एवरेज लाइन, दिस इज द एवरेज लाइन एंड वी हैव चेंज द ब्लू कलर, दिस द एवरेज लाइन। You have the, you want to show the data label, click on the data label, it will show the data label, higher data label. Median line and percentage line. This is the analytics tools. Your analytics every time change the according of numbers. Okay? So do you understand the column style chart, bar and column chart type? Sir? Mr. Krishnan, any problem?
No, this is not unmuting. That's
okay.
Yeah.
So we have discussed the line chart type. We have the line chart, area chart, and there is the stack area chart. Both are the like the same category, but visualize different visuals. So when you we have select the line chart here. And in the line chart, we give the flow, like the long data types. So we have entered here date and with the total T numbers. So I have total T numbers from the value sections, and automatically here is the count of the T numbers. And this is the yearly, monthly, quarterly. I want to day wise. So click here and see here the date wise. Okay, so when you have give the date on the axis level, your date will be grouped by different categories, just like table, just like date, year, month, quarter. Like if you want to show a little quarter, so keep the quarters and remove the all thing rest off, and if you want to only for day wise, so remove the rest of showing the day. And when you select, we have select the area chart. You can see here, area and line chart, both are the same. Only for difference, in the line chart, no have any colored the down of the line. But in the area chart, we have there is a colored down of the line. Okay. And when you select the stack chart, the same here. But in the stack chart, stack area chart, we have put the two numbers. Just like we have entered the, we have date wise and name wise. So name go the legend area. You can see here every line by according to your name. I put here. I have put the, give the status here. Legend here status. We have the three status, so we have the three lines. But give you the area chart, you can see here three area. So a small difference between a stack area chart and area chart. Okay, sir. A stack area chart,
yeah,
like your stack column chart. This is the total number of is the around 200 and with partition between your 200, just like your column chart. Line chart book and every line chart, area chart, we have the same formatting here. See here, same formatting you can see here, but you have select the area chart, formatting will be some change. Yeah, SAPs, plot area, background, borders. You can check here and apply your formatting. And we have also got the analytics, the trend line, minimum line, maximum line, average line, medium line. Percentage line. We have pick the percentage line and add the percentage. We have the 90% See here, your constant
okay.
line on the 90%. And you can also change your line style. This is a dot dash dot. You can also solid, and you can also dotted. When you do the solid, see here. And the position behind or front, behind the back side, and if you have front, upper side. And you can also the data labels here. कि व्हाट इज द योर परसेंटेज डेटा. ओके सो सेम फॉर्मेटिंग विथ योर ऑल्सो लाइन है लाइन चार्ट एरिया चार्ट एंड कर्सर एरिया चार्ट बट सम फीचर्स चेंज डिपेंडिंग योर विजुलाइजेशन दैट मीन्स कृष्ण. And second is the combo chart. This is the combo chart. So do you want to apply the line chart different and combo chart different charts? You can also use the combo charts. Just like we have clicked the combo chart here. And in the combo chart, we have name buys. So we have right here name. And total T number, count of the T numbers. So we have line value. Line value, this is the line value, this is the column value. So right here, column value. Okay. And we have also used the by status. This is the status. Okay. You also have status sorry T number here and status is here. There is the line value. You can also put the little line value. This is just like time taken. We have the line value. So we have different another x another secondary axis for the your line and see the line according this series. And we have also the line and cursor column. You can show here. And you can also the ribbon chart. This is the ribbon chart. We have time to values, counter numbers, time to remove here and name, legend here. For the ribbon chart, we have type your name and total T number. This is the ribbon chart. It's status bar.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
So today we discussed the two row, the column chart, line chart, area chart, combo chart, and ribbon chart, right? So please keep the practice and please see the every formatting and every analytics and apply the analytics. If you have any problem with any visualizations, please ping me. I give you the what's the support. Otherwise today tomorrow we say connect the same time 10 a.m. and we cover up the next session of next row. This is the your waterfall funnel and every chart right. This is the simple visualization. We have discussed over give you the overview of the visualizations, but when you create the live dashboard, then we have also give the tricks and advanced things on the this visualizations, every visualization, right? Okay. So join tomorrow at same time.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.